welcome back to a new video. So in today's video, we're going to be talking about how to stop letting what other people or what others think of you affect you. Now, I don't know about you, but this is something that I wish my inner child, my inner teen, young adult wishes that I would have known sooner. So I've really been looking forward to bringing this video to you because I have gotten some requests to cover this topic. So if you have any requests for future videos, be sure to leave them down in the comment section. I would love to read about them. Now, really quick, let's just talk about why this is important. What does this have to do with our mental health? Well, first of all, if we continually let what other people's opinions of us are affect our mental health, affect our decision making, then it starts to take a toll on how we view our own abilities. It makes us start questioning our own decisions and even our own identity. We may start to even wonder, is this really what I want to do? Is this really the career that I want to go into? Because everyone in my family is saying this. Life just comes with making so many decisions for ourselves, and it can be very hard to do when our own voice is drowned out by the voices of others, as well-intentioned as they may be sometimes, especially if you're not very secure in yourself or confident in your own abilities or in your own decision making. This can be very shattering and can really begin to start taking a huge toll on your mental health. So I do want to share with you in today's video also some coping skills of how you can start to combat this, so that way you have the tools to cope with these situations as they arise throughout your life. So tip number one is to dedicate some time to self-exploration, self-discovery, and asking yourself, what do I need to be fulfilled? What do I like? Making sure that you're questioning these things about yourself is very crucial and important to this topic, because if you don't know what you want, if you don't know what you like, what makes you feel fulfilled, what you want to do, who you want to date, all of these questions, if you haven't taken the time to know yourself very well and to know what you like, it can be very easy to have the voices of others drown out what you really want. And in those situations, it may be a lot easier to mold into what others expect of you. For instance, maybe everyone in your family is telling you that you should go into the nursing field or that you should start your own business, but deep down you really don't know if that's for you. Maybe you're even starting to feel anxious about making these decisions. So that is a good time to just hit pause, take some time to maybe step back and really do some self-exploration and ask yourself these questions. What do I like? What do I want to do with my life? Do I feel like this relationship is also benefiting me? Do I really want to move to this place? Do I want to go into this grad program? You know, you can't truly be secure in yourself and your identity and in who you are and what you want until you spend some time exploring that. And then when that situation arises, when you're over at your family's for a holiday dinner and they start questioning and telling you you should do this and you should do that, you can answer confidently, no, you know, I am doing this. This is what I really want to do. I've thought about this a lot and I am secure in my decision. Now, don't get me wrong, the advice and the support that comes from family and loved ones is so important and crucial to maintaining good mental health as well. It's a part of community care and self-care. So it's always going to be important for you to be honest with yourself and say, you know what? Are these habits that my family or my friends are trying to tell me about really healthy for me? Do I know that there may be some truth in this? Then it's a good idea to explore that as well. But if you're hearing all of these opinions and you feel uneasy because you're trying to make an important life decision, then really take that time to step back and to question what you truly want and what you're okay with. So tip number two is to recognize that you cannot control what other people think of you, what other people say to you, but you can control how you react and how you think. So someone will always have an opinion as to what's best for you, what you should be doing with your life, what the right path is for you to take. There will always be someone who will be giving you their opinion or who will be thinking it, but we shouldn't spend our time worrying about what others are thinking, especially if those people aren't even people that are in your close-knit support system, people who consistently have proven to have your back who have been there supporting you. So a quick little mini tip that also goes into this is to ask yourself, do I value this person's opinion? And is this person's opinion worth my own security and confidence being shaken? Is this person's opinion worth questioning and doubting myself? Now, recognizing that we can't control what other people think of us is easier said than done. It is not easy at all. It is something that will continually take practice, and that's why it is so important to continually question and ask ourselves, you know, does this person's opinion of me really matter to me? Because as you gradually learn to be secure in yourself and in your decision making and in what you want, then those voices gradually begin to drown out, and it becomes a lot easier for you to make decisions in the future and to be secure in yourself. Now, tip number three is to create an empowering mantra or saying that you can utilize when these situations arise or in your everyday life. Some really simple examples can be, I know what I'm doing, I believe in myself and in my dreams. And those are just a couple of examples, but it's just important for you to find something that works for you. So the last tip that I want to share with you is tip number four, and that is to set healthy boundaries. Now, this is going to be so crucial to this and to protecting your own mental health, your own peace, because if you do not set boundaries around the people that are continually questioning what you're doing and knowing that this is affecting your mental health, affecting your own self-worth, then this can just continually sow seeds of self-doubt, and nobody needs that, especially if you're having a hard time being easily affected by what other people think of you. So some examples of healthy boundary setting are, maybe you need to completely cut out someone from your life. Maybe the toxicity is just way too much to handle. I know for me, on a personal stance, I have had to do this along my own education journey because not everyone around me had been supportive. It is so important for you to feel empowered in this and for you to feel that autonomy that you're the one making this decision for yourself. You know, maybe another healthy boundary is that I'll only see this person once a month, or that when I do see these people, I will voice and let them know that what they are saying is intrusive and hurtful, and I will be honest with them about my opinion. So it's very important to start thinking about what kind of healthy boundaries you need to set for yourself. And that is it for today's video, everyone. I really hope you enjoyed it and that you found it helpful. If you are new to my channel, I want to invite you to hit that subscribe button, like this video, and leave me a comment if you would like to connect further. Thank you so much, and I will see you in my next video.